Reliable sources. You know, thanks to Donald Trump, immigration is front and center on English language newscasts like this one. But it's different on Spanish language newscasts. On Univision, the immigration debate is always front and center. Univision is by far the biggest Spanish language broadcaster in the United States. It is growing every year, and it proudly calls itself the voice of Hispanics in the U.S. Democratic candidate Martin O'Malley recently sought out Univision to pitch his immigration proposals. But on the flip side, some Republican candidates avoid Univision because they perceive that the channel is biased against the GOP, biased against conservative proposals on immigration. So what is the network's role? Where does it find itself in this mix? Well, the perfect person to ask is standing by. She's one of the most prominent anchors at Univision, nightly news anchor Maria Elena Salinas. Thank you so much for joining me.
It's my pleasure.
When we're talking about Spanish language media and talking about immigration, we have to talk about Donald Trump. We know that he's suing Univision. So I wonder, how does that affect Univision's coverage of Trump?
I don't think it really affects our coverage. I mean, we're covering Trump the way that Trump is being covered by everyone. It is of special interest, of course, to our audience because some of the derogatory comments that he made that day, the day that he launched his campaign, were directed at part of our audience, if not all of our audience. One thing that I think people need to understand is that you can't have it both ways. You can't say, I support immigrants as long as they're legal, but I don't support illegal aliens. By the way, we don't use the word illegal because a human being is not illegal. We use the word undocumented. So you can't insult undocumented Mexicans without insulting all Mexicans and all Hispanics. We come from the same region. We have the same blood. We have the same ancestors. And some had a better opportunity to cross the border than others. So for Hispanic voters, many of which have parents, grandparents that maybe arrived illegally, maybe they themselves were here illegally at one point, or they have friends or family members that are now here in this country without documents. This is a personal attack. So you cannot separate them. You can't have it both ways.
I know that Trump has done interviews with Univision and other Spanish language media. If you could ask him anything, what would you be asking him right about now?
You know, to be honest with you, I don't know that I want to interview Donald Trump because it would be a very predictable interview. The interviews that I have seen with him, some of the answers just don't make any sense. So what can you ask him? Even if you tell him the truth, if you give him facts, I don't expect that he is going to accept those facts because he's got his own facts. That's why I think the fact checkers must be having a field day, especially this past week.
I'm really interested in how Univision covers the topic of immigration because it's very different than how English language networks do. Let me put a quote on the screen that was really striking from the Los Angeles Times. This was a quote from a Martin O'Malley advisor, a former producer for Univision, who said, if the Spanish language media has 5 minutes to talk to a presidential candidate about anything, they will talk about immigration. Number one, do you think that's true? And number two, what do you think that signifies about the Hispanic audience?
Yes, it's true. If we have an opportunity to speak to any presidential candidate, immigration will definitely be one of the topics, not the only topic. Hopefully, they'll give us more than 5 minutes so we can talk about many other things. But one thing you need to understand that even though the Hispanic electorate does care about jobs and the economy, they care about education, they care about health care, they care very much also about immigration, not because they have an immigration problem, because voters are U.S. citizens and don't have an immigration problem, but because it affects the image of our community. Mm. It hurts our soul. So that will definitely affect their vote. In a way, I think we're adding to democracy so we can have a very healthy debate with two different sides, with two different realities. And the reality of the immigrants, you don't see in English language media. You see on Univision. Wish more people could have a translation device in their television so that they could see our coverage.
That's a very good point. But I do wonder if at some point the coverage shifts into advocacy. Is there a line that you think Univision's ever crossed into advocacy?
Well, you can call it advocacy. Advocacy journalism can be considered whenever you give more importance to one topic than another. But we're certainly not telling people who to vote for. I mean, we have campaigns constantly asking voters or asking immigrants first to become citizens, then to register to vote, and then to go out and vote. But not because we want them to vote for one candidate or another, but because we think it's important for Hispanics to understand not only what their rights are in this country, but also what their responsibilities are.
Do you think it's one of those cases where you've got critics working the refs, accusing Univision of biases, accusing Univision of being anti-Trump or anti-GOP in order to pressure you all to change your coverage?
No, you know, we're very aware. We're very aware of the criticism. Because we know this criticism exists, we are extra careful. We are very cautious of the words that we use, the graphics that we use, the scripts that are written to make sure that we are fair and balanced. And we are fair and balanced. And that's the way that we've done our coverage at all times. But when it comes to political coverage, you know, there's always more scrutiny on us than anyone else. And as you know, things can be interpreted in so many different ways. And because of the language barrier, sometimes the wrong message comes out or the wrong message is received.
And what do you say to people who are curious about the connections between one of the owners of Univision, Haim Saban, to Hillary Clinton? You know, he's a prominent fundraiser and supporter of Hillary Clinton. He's been very public about that. People wonder sometimes if that affects any of the news content on Univision. What's your answer to that?
It has not affected our news coverage at all. I mean, we've always known that one of our owners is supportive of Hillary Clinton, just like one of our previous owners was supportive of Republicans. He donated millions and millions of dollars, Mr. Perenchio, to Republicans, and that never affected our coverage either. So, no, there's never been any kind of influence in any way, shape, or form. I don't remember, and I have been an anchor here for more years than I'd like to mention, let's say a few decades, and we have never in this entire time had anyone in management ever come and tell us you need to give more emphasis to this candidate or you need to push this campaign or give more time to a specific party. That just has never happened.
Well, it's precisely because of the language barrier that I think people are curious about Univision, curious about Spanish language media. And I appreciate you being here to talk to us about it. Thank you.
It's my pleasure, Brian.
I'll ride the highway.
A piece of cheese. A simple act can forge a connection with the barkeep. And I'm making a metaphor for you. Cheese in this situation equals money. Just tip your bartender.
Welcome back to Reliable Sources. You know, thanks to Donald Trump, immigration is front and center on English language newscasts like this one. But it's different on Spanish language newscasts. On Univision, the immigration debate is always front and center. Univision is by far the biggest Spanish language broadcaster in the United States. It is growing every year, and it proudly calls itself the voice of Hispanics in the U.S. Democratic candidate Martin O'Malley recently sought out Univision to pitch his immigration proposals. But on the flip side, some Republican candidates avoid Univision because they perceive that the channel is biased against the GOP, biased against conservative proposals on immigration. So what is the network's role? Where does it find itself in this mix? Well, the perfect person to ask is standing by. She's one of the most prominent anchors at Univision, nightly news anchor Maria Elena Salinas. Thank you so much for joining me.
It's my pleasure.
When we're talking about Spanish language media and talking about immigration, we have to talk about Donald Trump. We know that he's suing Univision. So I wonder, how does that affect Univision's coverage of Trump?
I don't think it really affects our coverage. I mean, we're covering Trump the way that Trump is being covered by everyone. It is of special interest, of course, to our audience because some of the derogatory comments that he made that day, the day that he launched his campaign, were directed at part of our audience, if not all of our audience. One thing that I think people need to understand is that you can't have it both ways. You can't say, I support immigrants as long as they're legal, but I don't support illegal aliens. By the way, we don't use the word illegal because a human being is not illegal. We use the word undocumented. So you can't insult undocumented Mexicans without insulting all Mexicans and all Hispanics. We come from the same region. We have the same blood. We have the same ancestors. And some had a better opportunity to cross the border than others. So for Hispanic voters, many of which have parents, grandparents that maybe arrived illegally, maybe they themselves were here illegally at one point, or they have friends or family members that are now here in this country without documents, this is a personal attack. So you cannot separate them. You can't have it both ways.
I know that Trump has done interviews with Univision and other Spanish language media. If you could ask him anything, what would you be asking him right about now?
You know, to be honest with you, I don't know that I want to interview Donald Trump because it would be a very predictable interview. The interviews that I have seen with him, some of the answers just don't make any sense. So what can you ask him? Even if you tell him the truth, if you give him facts, I don't expect that he is going to accept those facts because he's got his own facts. That's why I think the fact checkers must be having a field day, especially this past week.
I'm really interested in how Univision covers the topic of immigration because it's very different than how English language networks do. Let me put a quote on the screen that was really striking from the Los Angeles Times. This was a quote from a Martin O'Malley advisor, a former producer for Univision, who said, if the Spanish language media has 5 minutes to talk to a presidential candidate about anything, they will talk about immigration. Number one, do you think that's true? And number two, what do you think that signifies about the Hispanic audience?
Yes, it's true. If we have an opportunity to speak to any presidential candidate, immigration will definitely be one of the topics, not the only topic. Hopefully, they'll give us more than 5 minutes so we can talk about many other things. But one thing you need to understand that even though the Hispanic electorate does care about jobs and the economy, they care about education, they care about health care, they care very much also about immigration, not because they have an immigration problem, because voters are U.S. citizens and don't have an immigration problem, but because it affects the image of our community. Mm. It hurts our soul. So that will definitely affect their vote. In a way, I think we're adding to democracy so we can have a very healthy debate with two different sides, with two different realities. And the reality of the immigrants, you don't see in English language media. You see on Univision. Wish more people could have a translation device in their television so that they could see our coverage.
That's a very good point. But I do wonder if at some point the coverage shifts into advocacy. Is there a line that you think Univision's ever crossed into advocacy?
Well, you can call it advocacy. Advocacy journalism can be considered whenever you give more importance to one topic than another, but we're certainly not telling people who to vote for. I mean, we have campaigns constantly asking voters or asking immigrants first to become citizens, then to register to vote, and then to go out and vote. But not because we want them to vote for one candidate or another, but because we think it's important for Hispanics to understand not only what their rights are in this country, but also what their responsibilities are.
Do you think this is one of those cases where you've got critics working the refs, accusing Univision of biases, accusing Univision of being anti-Trump or anti-GOP in order to pressure you all to change your coverage?
No, you know, we're very aware. We're very aware of the criticism. Because we know this criticism exists, we are extra careful. We are very cautious of the words that we use, the graphics that we use, the scripts that are written to make sure that we are fair and balanced, and we are fair and balanced. And that's the way that we've done our coverage at all times. But when it comes to political coverage, you know, there's always more scrutiny on us than anyone else. And as you know, things can be interpreted in so many different ways. And because of the language barrier, sometimes the wrong message comes out or the wrong message is received.
And what do you say to people who are curious about the connections between one of the owners of Univision, Haim Saban, to Hillary Clinton? You know, he's a prominent fundraiser and supporter of Hillary Clinton. He's been very public about that. People wonder sometimes if that affects any of the news content on Univision. What's your answer to that?
It has not affected our news coverage at all. I mean, we've always known that one of our owners is supportive of Hillary Clinton, just like one of our previous owners was supportive of Republicans. He donated millions and millions of dollars, Mr. Perenchio, to Republicans, and that never affected our coverage either. So, no, there's never been any kind of influence in any way, shape, or form. I don't remember, and I have been an anchor here for more years than I'd like to mention, let's say a few decades, and we have never in this entire time had anyone in management ever come and tell us you need to give more emphasis to this candidate or you need to push this campaign or give more time to a specific party. That just has never happened.
Well, it's precisely because of the language barrier that I think people are curious about Univision, curious about Spanish language media, and I appreciate you being here to talk to us about it. Thank you.
It's my pleasure, Brian.